हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर जे दुर्गा प्रसाद राव, एडिशनल डायरेक्टर इन एचओडी कंप्यूटर साइंस। आई एम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस श्री शंकराचार्य महाविद्यालय। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर आई विल बी टीचिंग यू अबाउट रजिस्टर ट्रांसफर लैंग्वेज एंड माइक्रो ऑपरेशंस। दिस कम्स अंडर यूनिट 2, paper 5 of the computer system architecture for the course MSc computer science first semester under Durg University. So let's begin. What is computer architecture? Set of data types, operations and features are called its architecture. It deals with those aspects that are visible to user level, and also it is a study of design of those parts of computer which actually work in the motherboard. So let's now see why computer architecture is needed. The reasons basically for computer architecture needed are to analyze or check maximum overall performance of a system, keeping with its constants, constraints. It is also used to bridge the performance gap between the slowest and fastest component in a computer. Also to study architecture design, search the space of possible design, evaluate the performance of design, choose, identify bottlenecks, redesign and repeat process. So what basically is computer organization? Basically computer concise with, that means every computer has CPU, input output devices, memory, bus connections, methods. You can see from the clip art already pasted in this particular slide. Now here is a block diagram. Under CPU, you have control unit, your arithmetic logic unit, which is short form as ALU. You have registers, main memory, disks, printers, that means output devices. And you also have input devices. Overall, this is the simple block diagram of computer. In general term, many call this CPU as brain of central processing unit. What basically it does, it executes the program stored in the main memory. It has several parts like control unit, arithmetic logic unit, registers. So what are registers? You can think registers as a simple day-to-day or daily-based registers or office-based register which make. Only thing is that they are here digitally or electronically maintained. So what are registers? They are high-speed memory, top of the memory hierarchy, and provide fastest way to access data. As I had already told, you can think as a register as a general-based register where data are recorded. And what are the some features or characteristics of registers? It has temporary results. Some useful registers are highlighted here. They are program counters. Program counters basically point to next instructions. Then you have instruction registers to hold instructions currently being executed. And also you have here a block diagram or a flow chart representing the hierarchical concepts of register. A few more registers types: user accessible registers, data registers, address registers, general purpose register and special purpose register. As the name suggests, general purpose registers are used for general purpose, whereas special purpose are bind only to focus on a particular work. A picture is depicted where you can see main memory, control unit, system clock, arithmetic logic unit, registers, and they have input and output port instruction. What basically is instructions? Instructions are basically three types: data handling and memory operations. That is, they have instructions as related to set, move, read, write, and arithmetic and logic instructions like add, subtract, multiply, or divide, and compare. This all comes under arithmetic logic unit. And then you have control flow to control the flow of the address buses. About bus, we will be studying in the coming slides. And what are complex instructions? Take many instructions off on other computers, saving many registers on the stack at once, moving large blocks of memory. And so when the process is a little bit clumsy, then you have to make sure that those are to be executed in correct order. Parts of instructions: opcode, which specifies the operations to be performed. And what are the operands? They have registers, values, values in the stack, other memory values, input output ports. Types of the operations: register operations. This basically deals with add, subtract, compare, and logical operations. You might be remembering in ALU also I had mentioned the same thing. Memory reference, all loads from memory. Multi-cycle instructions: integer, multiply, and divide, and all floating operations. Then you have fetch code, fetch, decode, execute cycle. You have instruction fetch, 32-bit instruction was fetched from the cache. Decode, execute, memory access, write back. Now here is the fetch, decode, execute circle. That is the instruction fetch unit moves to instruction decode unit, then to operand fetch unit, instruction execution unit, write back unit, and the blocks or address notations of those working is also being depicted here. Microprocess can identify by two main parameters. How to differentiate between process? One is speed in either megahertz or gigahertz. By speed you can identify the difference between processors, and also the processor is having featured with data bus, address bus, internal register, graphical bus, and all that. Well, data bus, known as front side bus, CPU bus, and processor side bus. Basically, as the name says, database is basically carries the data. It is used between CPU and main chipset. That is how to get the memory, how to work on the memory. And it has also defined to a particular size, that is 32-bit, 64-bit, and more. Two pictures are depicted here. Then you have a pictorial form or image form of database. That is, you can see how to recognize that is COM1, VG, LPT, and PS2. That is different types of port, integrated LAN, south bridge, and floppy drives. This is internal path of database. Input output with data transfer rates. That is super input output. Then you have south bridge, USB, and you can refer those things. Address bus. Address bus features include: it carries addressing information. Each wire carries a single bit. Width indicates maximum amount of RAM the processor can handle. Database and address bus are independent. And here is the image showing address bus, how address bus gets the work from CPU, memory, input, output, and how it delivers those works. How CPU works? A simple CPU with 4-bit address bus registers ABC, 4-bit, 8-bit program, 4-bit instructions, 4-bit data. And this is how it works. It was already told in CPU plate. Address bus is of 4 bits. So here is address bus. ALU, AB, that is IP, IC, register C, and instruction set sleep, load M, and M moves to A, then M moves to B, M is here memory, then A is set as memory 1, B is set as memory 2, and then both are added, that is A plus B, and it goes to C. Okay, and then it moves to counter register and finally process output. This is how CPU works. Again, the same thing with a different operation. The load M, A, load M, B, set A to M, set A, B to M, set C to M, and then A plus B goes to C. Binary bits address is being explained. And again, how data is moving is shown in pictorial form. Then load M. Now, since load A is already there, load B is to be loaded, and then most 010 is moved, and you can see in the next slide that both are moved. I must say you can see here this data is moved. Then add A plus B plus C, and you can see in the next slide both here are added. You can see the C result. Then again is result for the next operation, and in a move it works. So how bus system works? That is, different devices are connected. Devices could be printer, devices could be monitor, devices could be any peripheral device, and CPU is also CPU can also be seen in line with these devices. Then you have then you have different path for database, address bus, and control bus. These are some popular bus systems works. In that is, you have been shown Intel hard disk and how those things works. Okay. Address bus 4-bit, data bus 4-bit, control bus 2-bit. Then the same operation which we have done earlier in terms of instruction set is being depicted here, how the bus system works. That is control 2-bit, and example is being sorted out. The marking in blue shows that the data is for data bus, red, or you can say pink, is for address bus, and control bus is depicted later here. And here how you get the data, that is control bit data is being loaded, read write process is done, and then data bus is loaded. Then you have control bit, then again those data is being uploaded, and this way you can, the bus works out working. In this way the bus works out for database, address bus, and control bus. So this is the end of unit 2 of MSc Computer Science. All the topics related to unit 2 has been covered. Next we'll continue in different presentation. Thank you very much. So that was unit 2 of MSc Computer Science, first semester, paper 5 of Computer System Architecture. My email ID has already been given. In case of any doubts or queries, you can mail me. I would be happy to help you out. Thank you very much.